Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this letterhead in Word. So before we start designing, we need to place all of our graphics into our headers and footers. And the reason we need to do that is because if you then need to type onto a second or third page, it will ensure that all of your graphics move to the second and third page. If you don't, you're going to have to copy all of the graphics over to any subsequent pages. So I'm going to double click at the top of my page. And as you can see now, I'm in the headers and footers. So my first graphic is going to be a square. So I'm just going to go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and select a basic square, and then just click and drag out a square. Now all graphics that are inserted into Word, such as a shape, come with a border and a fill color. Now if you want to change those, just click on the shape, go to Shape Format, and here you can see Shape Outline and Shape Fill. Shape Outline, we're just going to get rid of that outline by selecting No Outline. And then Shape Fill, if we click on the drop down, we're just going to select a dark blue. And then we're just going to pop that up there and it just extend that out. All of this you can adjust at the end, so you don't have to be perfect about it now. The next thing is another shape, so Insert, Shapes, and then I'm going to go down to this shape here, and then just click and drag out that shape. Now for this tutorial I want this shape to go this way, so I'm just going to grab this square, and I'm going to move it across, and that just mirrors that shape that we've inserted. Again, it's come with a border, so I'm just going to select it, go to Shape Format, Shape Outline, No Outline. And then I'm just going to pop that up there. It's going to reduce the size of it a little bit. Then I'm going to grab this square or this rectangle that we've already inserted, and then I'm going to copy and paste it. Now you can use Command or Control C followed by Command or Control V. So if I press Command or Control C, you have to then deselect that shape before hitting Command or Control V. Alternatively, I can just select that rectangle, hold my Alt key down and click and drag out another shape. Then again, I'm going to reduce the size of it and I'm just going to move it up to there. Now to ensure it's level with this rectangle, I'm just going to make sure this is selected, hold down my Command or Control key, click on this rectangle here, go to Shape Format and I'll go all the way along to Align, click on the drop down and select Align to Bottom. And you can see this one's dropped here, so we can either move them both up or we can just select this bit of the rectangle and move it up. But you can see it's moved both of them. So we can always deselect one and just manipulate it. If you want to deselect these shapes, you'll notice if I click anywhere here, it doesn't do anything. You have to click in the header or footer to deselect anything. Once you're happy with that, we want a little slant on the side of this rectangle here. So I'm just going to duplicate this shape, select it. I'm going to hold down my Alt key and I'm just going to make another one of these shapes. And then all I'm going to do is just change the color of this shape to white. So select it, Shape Format, Shape Fill, and then turn it white. And there you can see it's created that little slant across that rectangle. I'm just going to grab this rectangle again, hold my Alt key down, click and drag out another one, and then I'm just going to pop that down the bottom here for the bottom graphics. And then again, select this white shape here, Alt key, click and drag another shape, and then we're just going to make sure that that rectangle has the same slant on or angle on the edge there. I'm just going to move that down so it doesn't interfere with any text. Once I'm happy with all of this, we need to then insert the text and logos. So first of all, I'm just going to insert a random logo. Here I'm just going to use an icon. So you'll have your own logo. I'm just going to select this A. When you insert your logo, you might find that it goes behind this blue rectangle, but you can see the outline here. Don't worry, just make sure it's still selected. go to graphics format, go to wrap text, click on the drop down and select in front of text. Now mine's black at the moment, I'm just going to change it white. So graphics format, graphics fill, just going to turn that white. And that would just be a logo. Now some text, I'm going to go to insert, text box, draw text box, click and drag out a text box. Now, once again, all text boxes have a black border and a white fill color. We can get rid of both of those in the same way that we change the color of these shapes. Go to shape format, shape outline, no outline, shape fill, click on the drop down, no fill. Then I can just type. You can't see, I'm just going to select it all by Command or Control A, which will select all of my text. Go to the Home tab and go to the font color icon here. I'm just going to select white. You can click on the drop down and select any color of your choice. I'm just going to make that font bigger. I'm going to go to this increase font size tool here and I'm going to make it bold. Maybe take it up one more. There we go. And then this is just your logo name and tagline. I'm just going to duplicate this again, Alt or Option, click and drag out another box. I'm going to deselect them both because I only want to select this box here. Double click inside, Command or Control A to select all of the text. And then again, you can type your tagline. You don't have to. Command or Control A again to select it all. I'm just going to reduce the size of this font by the decrease font size tool. I'm going to take the bold off as well and reduce that to 14. Then I'm just going to make sure that these two Y letters line up by using my arrow key. I can't do that because I'm actually within the text. I'm actually inside the text box. So I need to deselect it, reselect it, then I can use my arrow keys. I'm just going to put that bit closer together. Now all I'm going to do is duplicate this text box again, holding down the Alt key, and then drag it down to the bottom. Once I'm happy with the placement of these two pieces of text, I'm going to group them together. So I need to select the one box, hold my Command or Control key down, select the other box, go to Shape Format, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And then you can see they move around together. Just makes life a little bit easier. Now, if you want to check your design, you need to double click in the center here. Now, what will happen is you can see they're grayed out. Don't worry about that. That just tells you that all of your graphics and your text is in the headers and footers. When you save this to a PDF, it will look absolutely fine. So just to check your alignment, you're happy with everything, you can just go into this section, the main section, and then double click at the top here, and you'll go back into the headers and footers. So I'm going to grab this text box here again, and I'm going to duplicate it for the top here. Now I'm going to put it here because I just need to change the color of this text because it needs to be black. But if I put it up here, I won't be able to see it. So double click inside, Command Control A to select the text, go to the Home tab, font color, and I'm just going to change that to black and then move it to here. Now here is a section, you don't have to put text here, but this is a section that if you want to write a little bit about your business, then you can pop it in here. So I'm just going to double click inside, Command or Control A, delete that text, and then just insert some more text. There we go. Now I'm going to come back and check the placement of this once I've finished down at the bottom, but I'm just going to copy and paste this text box again, holding down my Alt key, click and drag out another one. We're going to use that for the telephone number, and then again, click and drag out for the website. So in here, we'll just put the website, we'll put the phone number. And here we'll just put the website. Now, again, you can line these up perfectly. If you select one of the boxes, hold the Command or Control key down, select the other one, go to Shape Format, go to Align, Align to Top, and then all of the top line of text will be perfectly lined up. Next, we're going to go along to this set of text here, and this will be your address. It's going to change the color. I'm going to double click in the middle here just to check the alignment of everything. We're just going to pop this up a little bit. So I'm going to double click down here. I'm going to use my arrow keys just to move that text up a bit. And then what I can do is just grab these, move them up a bit. Oh, with one nudge. And then I'm going to actually select them all and align them. So click on one of the text boxes, hold down the Command or Control key, select them all, shape format, align, align to top. There we go. And they will all be lined up across the top there. Then we're just going to enter in some little logos for the phone number and the email. So we go to insert, icons, over to icons. And in here, I shall type phone and select this phone here. Click insert. Again, it's disappeared behind this shape at the top here. So without deselecting it, just go to graphics format, wrap text in front of text, and then we can just drag it down to the bottom and resize it. Just grab the corners and then just resize it until you're happy. Then back over to the icons again, and I'm just going to type in globe, select this icon, click insert. Again, you won't be able to move it. So if I try and move it, you'll see that you can't move it. Right click on it, go to wrap text. Sorry, you can't see it, but it's in front of text again. And then we're just going to resize it and pop it next to this one. Now you can align them, but because the icons aren't always lined up with the same margins, you'll find that they don't always align correctly. So the best thing to do is to use your arrow keys to move the icons or just to use your mouse. So I think I'm just going to make my logo a little bit bigger. And then I might make this text a little bit bigger, double click inside, Command or Control A, go to the Home tab, increase text, double click in the center, perfect. So now what you need to do is realize that your cursor is up here. Now I can just hit the Enter key and move it down, but you can tidy that up a little bit by actually going over to the rulers. If you can't see your rulers, click View, Rulers, and just make sure the rulers are checked. And when you go to the rulers, if I click, you can see a line appears. That's where your cursor will start. So if I pull that line down, you can see my cursor has now moved to here. So then when you move to the second page, you won't start typing up in the top of the headers and footers again. So I'm just going to enter in my text. There we go. I can just nudge that down. I might pop that down one more space. There we go. Perfect. Now again, you can see that this will grey out, but if I just hit my return key at the bottom here and I want a new page, you can see that all of that graphics and text will just hop over to the second page. And that's why we've put it into the headers and footers. If we hadn't, when I went to the second page, this would be completely blank. So if I now go ahead and save this as a PDF, go to File, Save As. I'm going to save this to my desktop, go down to File Format, go down to PDF and click Save. Then I'm going to open up that document. Let's just reduce the size of it. And you can see now that all the colors are vibrant and it looks absolutely perfect and ready to send on. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.